Recall that the topic of the last segment were linear combinations of vectors. I described there what a linear combination is in a few different ways, but one way to define it is to say that a vector W is a linear combination of vectors v1 through vp if there exist some scalars c1 through cp such that we can obtain W by multiplying the vector v1 by c1, v2 by c2, and so on, and then adding these products together. As you may remember, in that last segment, we also dealt with some problems where the goal was to figure out if a given vector W is a linear combination of some other vectors. And let's start now with one more problem of the same type. Let's say then that we are given two vectors in R3, v1, which is the vector 1, 0, 0, and v2, which is the vector 0, 1, 0, and that we are also given a vector w with coordinates 1, 1, and 3, and we want to check if this vector w can be expressed as a linear combination of v1 and v2. Now, in the last segment, I showed you that problems of this kind can be always solved by setting up and solving a vector equation, but here we will take a different route. Namely, notice that by definition, linear combinations of v1 and v2 are vectors of the form c1 times v1 plus c2 times v2, where c1 and c2 are some scalars. In other words, every linear combination of these vectors will be obtained by multiplying the first vector, 1, 0, 0, by some scalar c1, multiplying the second vector, 0, 1, 0, by some scalar c2, and then by adding these products. Now, when we perform these scalar multiplications and addition, the vector we obtain will be a vector of this form. Its first coordinate will be c1, the second coordinate will be c2, and the third coordinate will be 0. This is then how every linear combination of v1 and v2 will look like. Its first and second coordinates can be arbitrary numbers, but the last coordinate will be always 0. Now, we see right away that the vector w is not a vector of this form, because its last coordinate is 3. From here we obtain then that w is not a linear combination of v1 and v2. Now, this argument is very simple, but what is interesting about it is that it can be illustrated by a nice geometric picture. This goes as follows. Since we are dealing here with vectors in R3, these vectors can be represented geometrically by arrows in the three-dimensional space. The vector v1 has coordinates 1, 0, 0, so it corresponds to the arrow that goes 1 unit along the x-axis. And in the same way, since the coordinates of v2 are 0, 1, 0, this vector corresponds to the arrow that goes 1 unit along the y-axis. These two arrows point in different directions, but what they have in common is that they both lay flat on the xy plane. Next, as we have noticed, if we take any linear combination of v1 and v2, then this will be a vector whose last coordinate is 0. This means that any such vector will not go up or down, but it will also belong to this xy plane. Now, if we picture here the vector w, then we see that this vector does not belong to the xy plane, it sticks out of it. This is because the last coordinate of w tells us that to get to the end of this vector, we need to move 3 units along the z-axis. So, in other words, the end of w is 3 units above the xy plane. So again, all linear combinations of v1 and v2 are vectors that belong to the xy plane. The vector w does not belong to this plane. And so this picture shows that w is not a linear combination of v1 and v2. What this example illustrates is that it is sometimes useful to look at the collection of all possible linear combinations of some specified vectors, because it makes geometrical sense. This is what we see in this picture. The collection of all possible linear combinations of vectors v1 and v2 is geometrically represented by the xy plane, since linear combinations of v1 and v2 are precisely the vectors that belong to this plane. This motivates the following definition. If we have some vectors v1 through vp in Rn, then the span of these vectors is the set of all possible linear combinations of these vectors. To illustrate this definition, let's look again at the vectors v1 and v2. By definition, the span of these two vectors is the set of all linear combinations of these vectors. This is the same as saying that the span of v1 and v2 is the set of all vectors of the form c1 times v1 plus c2 times v2, where c1 and c2 are some scalars, so some real numbers. As we have previously noticed, this set is in turn the same as the set of all vectors whose first and second coordinates are arbitrary numbers, and the last coordinate is 0. As you can see, span of v1 and v2 consists then of infinitely many vectors, but here we have a few concrete examples of vectors that are in the span. And so, first of all, this vector, 2, 3, 0, is in the span of v1 and v2, since it is a linear combination of v1 and v2. It can be obtained by taking 2 times the vector v1 and adding to it 3 times the vector v2. Next, the 0 vector is in the span since it can be obtained by multiplying both v1 and v2 by 0 and adding the results. And the vector minus 5, 4, 0 is also in the span, since it can be obtained by taking minus 5 times v1 and adding to it 4 times v2. It is equally easy to give examples of vectors that are not in the span of v1 and v2. For instance, the vectors 1, 1, 3, 0, 0, 1 and minus 5, 4, 7 are not in the span, since the last coordinates of these vectors are non-zero, and this means that these vectors cannot be obtained as linear combinations of v1 and v2. As you see, in this example, it was very easy to determine which vectors are in the span and which vectors are not, but that's because the vectors we were dealing with here, v1 and v2, are very simple vectors. Here is then a more difficult situation. We have here three vectors, v1, v2 and v3, which are again vectors in R3, and so we can consider the span of these three vectors. We also have here a vector w, and let's say that we would like to check whether w is in the span of v1, v2 and v3 or not. Now, Since the vectors we have here are more complicated than the ones from the previous example, we don't see immediately if W is in the span or not, so we will need to work on it a bit. We will proceed then as follows. Recall that by definition, saying that the vector W is in the span of V1, V2 and V3 is the same thing as saying that W is a linear combination of these three vectors. Next, remember that saying that W is a linear combination of V1, V2 and V3 is the same as saying that the vector equation x1 times v1 plus x2 times v2 plus x3 times v3 equals to w has a solution. So, taking those things together, we obtain that the vector w is in the span of v1, v2 and v3 if and only if this vector equation has a solution. The upshot of this reasoning is that in order to check if W is in the span, we just need to solve this vector equation. If this equation has a solution, then W is in the span. If it has no solutions, then it is not. Now, from this point on, we can proceed as usual. So, we write the augmented matrix of our vector equation, which will look like this. We perform its row reduction, and this gives us the following reduced matrix. Now, what we see right away is that in this reduced matrix, we don't have a leading one in the column of constants, and this essentially solves our problem, since this means that the vector equation is consistent, it has a solution, and this automatically tells us that the vector W is in the span of the vectors v1, v2 and v3. If we want to be more precise though, then we can write down the solutions of this equation. As you can see, we don't have here any three variables, so we actually have only one solution, and this solution is x1 equals to minus 2, x2 equals to minus 1, and x3 equals to 1. Now, if we plug these numbers into our vector equation, then we see that W can be obtained as a linear combination of V1, V2 and V3 by taking minus 2 times V1, subtracting from it V2 and adding V3. And so, we obtained that W is a linear combination of V1, V2 and V3, and as a consequence, W is in the span of these vectors.